Welcome students. In the last exercise we have learned how to do the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of polynomials. Today we are going to learn another two more methods of doing the division of polynomials. The first one is called as synthetic division and the second one is called as linear division. Now first, how to do the synthetic division of polynomials. So we'll take an example and see how to do the division of polynomials by synthetic method. Now in practice set 3.3 practice set, you have got divide each of the following polynomials by synthetic division and also by linear division. So first we'll see how to do the division by synthetic method, and then we'll learn how to do it by linear division. So we'll take an example and see how to do it. Now you've got the fifth problem. You've got x to the power of 4 minus 3x square minus x. So this has to be divided by x plus 4. So here this is the polynomial which has to be divided by x plus 4. So now whenever you want to do the synthetic division, you have to first write the polynomial in the coefficient form, because we need to know what are the coefficients of the given polynomial. So here first we'll write this in the coefficient form. First we need to write it in the index form. So x to the power of 4, after 4 you need to get x cube, so you have to write it as plus 0 x cube. Then you have got the x square term, so you are writing it as minus 3 x square. After x square you are supposed to get x term, so you'll write it as 0 x, then the constant. So from here write down what are the coefficients here. So coefficient form will be 1 comma 0 minus 3 0 and minus 8. So after you write it in the coefficient form, so these coefficients what you have got, you just write one beside the other by leaving a small gap in between them, 0 minus 8. So write all the coefficients, put a vertical line, then draw a horizontal line by leaving a small gap in between them. Now this is the divisor. So the divisor's constant what you have got, that has to be taken with the opposite sign. Here you have got plus 4. If you have got plus 4, you have to do the division by minus 4. If you have got minus 4, you have to take the value as a plus 4. And after that, for the first term, for each and every problem, the first term will be 0. So 1 plus 0, you'll get it as a 1. Then multiply these two, minus 4 into 1, that is minus 4. Then add these two, you will get it as a minus 4. Then multiply these two again and write the value here. Minus 4 into minus 4 is a 16 plus 16. Now 16 minus 3 will be 13. Now next what you have to do is, you have to multiply these two. 13 into minus 4. So you will get this as a minus 52. So after multiplying it, again simplify this, you will get it as a minus 52. After minus 52, again you have to multiply these two and write the term here. So when you do the multiplication, minus into minus will become plus. Then 4 2's are 8 and 4 5's are 20. So you will get 208. Now when you simplify this, you will get the answer as a 200. So this completes the synthetic division. So what we have done here is, we have written the coefficients what you have got of this dividend. This is called as the dividend and this is called as the divisor. So write down the dividend in the coefficient form. Write the coefficients one beside the other like this. Then from the divisor, whatever is the constant, take it with the opposite sign and write it here. And for all the problem, the first division, write the value here as 0, then add it, 1 plus 0 is 1, then multiply these two, minus 4 into 1 will be minus 4, so 0 minus 4 is minus 4, then multiply minus into minus, plus 16, 16 minus 3 you will get it as 13, then 13 into minus 4 will be minus 52, then simplify these two, you will get minus 52. Minus 52 into minus 4 is minus 208. So then you simplify this, you will get it as a 200. So this completes the division. after the division is completed, the last value that you get here is the remainder, and the remaining numbers will represent the coefficient. So this, the coefficient is here, it is in the coefficient form. So you have to write this in the using the variable as whatever is the variable given here, you have to write it down in the index form, and that represents the quotient. So these values represent the quotient, and this is called as the remainder. So now this quotient, what you have got, is in the coefficient form. So this, when you have to write it in the index form, you have got 1, 2, 3, 4 terms are there. If you have got 4 terms, 4 minus 1, 3. So you have to write it with the x cube as the first term. Then you will get minus 4x square. Then you will get plus 13x. Then you will get minus 52. So quotient is this, and this is the remainder. Then further they have told to write the expression in the form of quotient and the remainder. So you have to write this expression in the form of quotient. So this is a quotient and this is a remainder. So at the end, when you write the final answer, you have to write what is the quotient and you have to write what is the remainder. So this completes the problem. So this is how you do the synthetic division. So we'll take one more example and see how you are going to do the synthetic division. So you have got the third problem from exercise 3.3, that is y cube minus 216. This has to be divided by y minus 6. So when you do the division, now this is the dividend and this is the divisor. So the dividend should always be written in the coefficient form. So to write it in the coefficient form, first we'll write this in the index form. So you will get y cube plus 0y square plus 0y minus 216. So now here, when you write it in the coefficient form, you get it as 1, 0, 0, minus 216. So this is the coefficient form of this y cube minus 216. Then this coefficient form, the coefficients what you have got, write it one beside the other by leaving a certain gap. 0, minus 216. So write a vertical, draw a vertical line and a horizontal line. Now here you have got minus 6. When you have got minus 6, you have to take it with the opposite sign, that is plus 6. The first value will always be 0. So 1 plus 0 is 1. Then 6 ones are 6. So write it here. 0 plus 6 is 6. 6 6 are 36. 0 plus 36 is 36. Then 36 into 6 is equal to 216. 6 6 are 36, carry 3 to the next place. 6 3 is 18, 18 plus 3 is 21. So you'll get minus 216 and plus 216, where you get the answer as 0 when you simplify it. So this last term represents the remainder, and this is the quotient which is in the coefficient form. So this coefficient form has to be written in the index form. So you will get this as, now here you have got 3 terms. When you have got 3 numbers, you have to start with the square. So since here it is the variable here is y, you have to start with the y square plus 6y plus 36. So this will be the quotient, and you get the remainder is equal to 0. So this is how you do the synthetic division of numbers. Now let us see how to do the division of the polynomial by linear method. So now when you are using the linear method, now this is a given problem, practice set 3.3, I have taken the fourth problem. So using this, you have to divide this polynomial by x plus 3 using the linear method. So when you are using the linear method, what you are supposed to do is each and every term you have to express it in terms of a divisor. So to express it in terms of, the first thing what you have to do is just arrange the terms. After cube you have got square, so just rearrange it. So you will get 2x to the power of 4 plus 3x cube minus 2x square plus 4x. So arrange in an order before you do the division. Now each and every term of this dividend you have to express it in terms of x plus 3. So the first step what we'll do is, first we'll write x plus 3, that is the divisor. to this divisor x, what should I multiply to get 2x to the power of 4? So I have to multiply this one by 2x cube, because 2x cube into x will be 2x to the power of 4. But when I do the multiplication here, I am getting an extra term, that is 2 into 3, that is 6x cube. So this is with plus sign, so I have to write with minus 6x cube plus 2 into 3, 6x cube. So it is plus 6x cube, so I have to write with the opposite sign as minus 6x cube. Then all the remaining terms will repeat it as it is. 3x cube minus 2x square plus 4x. The next step what you have to do here is 2x cube into x plus 3. These are like terms. When you got like terms, simplify it. So you'll get minus 3x cube, and write the other term as it is, x square plus 4x. Now what you have to do is this you have to express in the form of x plus 3. So when you write it in the form of x plus 3, write the first term as it is, x plus 3. Now this I'll first write it as x plus 3. To this, what should I multiply to this to get this term minus 3x cube? So to get minus 3x cube, I have to write it as minus 3x square. Minus 3x square into x will be minus 3x cube. But what I've got the extra term, minus into plus is minus. Minus 9x square will be extra. You've got minus 9x square. So you have to write here as plus 9x square. Then write the other term, minus 2x square plus 4x. The next step you got 2x cube into x plus 3 minus 3x square as it is into x plus 3. Then simplify this one. When you simplify, you will get it as 7x square. Then write this 4x as it is. The next step, 2x cube into x plus 3 minus 3x square into x plus 3. Now this term, express it in the form of x plus 3. So I'll write that x plus 3 here. Now what should I multiply to this x to get 7x square? So I have to multiply that one by 7x. 7x into x will be 7x square. So when I multiply 7 into x, I'll get 7x square. But the extra term that I've got is 7x into 3 is 21x. Since this is with plus sign, I have to take with minus 21x, then write the 4x as it is. Now next step, repeat everything as it is into x plus 3 minus 3x square into x plus 3 as it is plus 7x into x plus 3 as it is, then minus 21x plus 4x. Minus 21 plus 4, you will get it as minus 17x. The next step what you have to do is, now express this in terms of x plus 3. So for that, all the remaining terms write it as it is. 2x cube into x plus 3 minus 3x square into x plus 3 plus 7x into x plus 3. Now, first I'll write x plus 3. To this, what should I multiply to get minus 17x? So I have to multiply by minus 17. Minus 17 into x is minus 17x, but minus 17 into 3 will be minus 51. So since I've got minus 51, I have to write it as plus 51, the extra term. So now here, from the first, second, third and the fourth expression, the common term is x plus 3. So that can be taken out as x plus 3 as common. So when you take x plus 3 as common, then here you are left with 2x square, here you are left with minus 3x square, and here you are left with 7x, and here you are left with minus 17. So this is the term that you get when you take out x plus 3 common from all this. Then this plus 51, you have to write it as it is, plus 51. So this is dividend into quotient plus remainder. So this is the divisor, this is the quotient, and this is the remainder. So this is how you do the synthetic, how you do the linear division of the expression. So we'll take one more problem and see how you have to do the linear division. With one more example, you will be clear with the concept. Y cube minus 216. This you are supposed to divide. This is the third problem from the exercise, which I have already done it using synthetic division. Using linear division, we'll see how you are going to do it. So y cube minus 216, you have to divide that one by y minus 6. So now here y minus, I told you each and every term you have to express in terms of y minus 6. So the first term, when I express it as y minus 6, what should I multiply to this to get y cube? So to get y cube, I have to multiply by y square. So y square into y is y cube. So the extra term that I am getting here is minus 6y square. Since I am getting minus 6y square, I have to write it as plus 6y square. Then write the next term minus 216 as it is. The next step, y square into y minus 6 plus. Now this you have to express it in terms of y minus 6. So y minus 6, I write it as it is. To this y, what should I multiply to get 6y square? So I have to multiply by 6y. 6y into y is 6y square. But the extra term that I've got is 36y, minus 36y. So I'll write it as a plus 36y. Then I'll write the last term, minus 216. So the next step, y square, all this, you have to repeat it as it is. Plus 6y into y minus 6. Now this I have to express in terms of y minus 6. So y minus 6, I'll write it as it is. Then to this y, what should I multiply to get 36? So I have to multiply, I have to write it as a plus 36. 36 into y is plus 36. But when I multiply this one, I will get this one as a minus 216. Since it is minus, I have to write with plus. Plus 216, and this minus 216, repeat it as it is. Now these two gets cancelled. From these three terms, the constant is, the common term is y minus 6. So write it as y minus 6. Then you will get y square plus 6y, and here y minus 6 is taken out as common, so you will be left with plus 36, and here the both the terms gets cancelled, so you will get it as 0. So this is divisor into quotient plus remainder. So this is the divisor, this is the, this represents the quotient and this represents the remainder. So this is how you do the linear division for any given polynomial.